The Sunday heavy downpour also ravaged several gardens and caused landslides that blocked several roads in the area. Gloria Wimana, who lost his husband and two sons, explains the events that led to the death of her family members. I was preparing food when it started drizzling. My husband and the boys rushed into the main house in search for shelter. But shortly after, I saw the lightning and then heard the children yelling. Upon running to the house, I found them dead. I alerted my neighbors, who rushed to my rescue. Wimana has decried the unfortunate incident that befell her family, calling for support from well-wishers. I am worried about how I will be able to survive from now on, now that my people are gone. I pray that I get support in the life ahead. Residents have commented on the disaster that befell them. We have just arrived from Chenjojo, where we're working, and when we reached here, I let him go home. As I left for my house, I was shocked to hear bad news that my friend had died in this shocking way. Our neighbor has been good to us, and we cannot bear the news that he's no more. I last talked to my brother in December when I was inviting him to my party. When he came back, I was in Kabale, and my hope was for us to reconnect again. It is very unfortunate that he has died. The police spokesperson for Chigezi region, Eli Mate, says that Ambrose Kanunu and his sons, Justus Asimwe, aged 7, and Arnold Habomugisha, aged 5, were killed at around 3 p.m. as rain pounded their village and other parts of the districts for about an hour.
They were struck by lightning on the 30th of this March at around 2 p.m. during a heavy downpour.
It was somber as locals and relatives of the deceased had gathered to prepare for the send-off of the trial, which will be tomorrow. Report compiled by Job Namanya for the news.